Prepare the required tools. Choose the right part to mold line. Normally, the mold can be made in two pieces and also can be multi-pieces for complex products. Pile up the clay under the mold line. The clay cannot be too hard, and it cannot be any gaps between the mold and the clay. Smooth the surface of the clay with your moistened fingers. After fixing the clay, dig in the holes evenly on the clay to make a latch. The latch should be about 1 centimeter away from the mold. Coat the original mold surface with release agent, Vaseline. According to the complicated structure of the size of the products, we choose the type of silicone rubber which has a low viscosity and hardness. Mix silicone rubber and curing agent evenly. The proportion of the curing is 2% to 5%. Then put them into the vacuum container to pump the air out of the silicone rubber. Vacuum pump should be minus 0.1 mA, which will avoid the mold from bubbles and guarantee quality. Or you can reduce the catalyst if you don't have a vacuum machine, which release the air bubbles by extending the curing time. After vacuum pumping, brush the first layer of silicone rubber evenly on the mold. The first layer of silicone rubber should be thinner than 1 mm, which is to cover the mold and the clay thinly. Brush the second layer of silicone rubber till the first one is cured. After brushing the second or the third layer of silicone rubber, cover the gauze. When the silicone stops flowing, the gauze can increase the tension and strength of the mold. According to the size of the product, add one more layer of gauze. Generally, it will not cover more than 2 layers of gauze. Make the resin out mold after the silicone rubber mold is solidified. It wouldn't need to paint Vaseline on the mold as silicone rubber will not stick with resin. Paint a layer of resin evenly first and cover a layer of glass fiber. Then paint a layer of resin. The glass fiber can increase the tension and strength of the outer mold. A big mold should be covered 3 to 5 layers of glass fiber, while the small one should be covered 1 to 3 layers. Separate the mold till the resin solidified completely. Clean the clay, dry it with an air gun. Brush Vaseline on the surface of silicone rubber and original mold. Then, repeat the steps above. After gypsum cured, take out the outer mold and trim silicone mold and gypsum outer mold. We make some holes by the electric drill on the mold of the linking part for fastening the mold by the screw. The process is done. The silicone rubber mold can be used into production after 24 hours and it should be stored in ventilated, cool, and dry place.